Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is ngNews with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Matthieu Riegler is a member of the Angular team, and one of his main tasks is to work on and improve the official documentation. According to Matthieu, there is a lot of misunderstanding in the way how the tracking function in the for loop works. Because of that, Matthieu has now created a demo where you can see the different strategies and what impact they have on the way how Angular manipulates the DOM. In Matthieu's example, objects are recreated within an interval, that means their object reference change within every cycle. It's also the reason why the track strategy by identity, that's the object reference, is the worst. The $index strategy is good because it updates only the property bindings and doesn't throw away the DOM elements. The best in terms of reusing existing DOM elements is the tracking via a property of these objects. This is because he's incrementing the IDs with every run, and that means 9 out of 10 objects have IDs equal to the ones from before. So their DOM elements are reused, and the object with the new ID causes also and only a new DOM element. There is no best tracking strategy. They all depend on the use case. NX, an extension to the Angular CLI, had a hard week. Their deployment process got compromised and the attackers managed to publish malicious packages. When these things happen, it's always very important how the victim reacts. And in this case, the reaction was quite good. NX published a detailed timeline about the attack. Packages were out in the open for about 4 hours, then got completely removed. So if you're living in Europe and you're on your night shift on August the 27th, you installed NX packages or updated the NX plugin in VS Code between the time of 4:30 and 4:30, you have been affected. To find if and what to do, head to the official report. There is also an email where you can get direct help. Angular Space, a hub for learning Angular, had its first live podcast. Host was Armen Vardanyan and the guest was Matthieu Riegler. They discussed the future of Angular, and without surprise, it was all about signals. And since Matthieu is monitoring the Angular repository quite closely, he also had a lot of things to share about the upcoming signal forms. Then we also have a new Angular newsletter. It is called Angular Digest and is maintained by Jérôme Grinot. The two end-to-end testing frameworks, Cypress and Playwright, were also released in new versions. Cypress is now on version 15 and Playwright is on 55. And a new UI library for Angular under the name ZardUI was also released. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.